今年は現在の新型コロナウイルスの状況を踏まえ、参拝をしかるべき時期まで延期し、ここ官邸において会見を行うことになりました。新型コロナウイルスについては、引き続き1日の感染者数が3000人を超え、重症者数も高い水準で推移をしており、非常に厳しい状況だと認識をいたしております。まずは年末年始も最前線で戦っておられる医療、介護をはじめとする関係の方々、そして外出や帰省を控えていただいている国民の皆様に心から感謝を申し上げる次第です。政府としては、こうした厳しい状況を踏まえ、改めてコロナ対策の強化を図っていきたい、こういうふうに思います。まずは感染対策、さらに水際対策、医療体制、ワクチンの早期接種、この4点で強力な対策を講じることにいたしました。第一に感染対策です。12月の人出は多くの場所で減少しましたが、特に東京都近県の繁華街の夜の人出はあまり減っておりませんでした。昨年以来対策に取り組む中で判明したことは、経路不明の感染原因の多くは飲食によるものと専門家が指摘をいたしております。したがって飲食でのリスクを抑えることが重要です。そのため夜の会合を控え、飲食店の時間短縮にご協力いただくことが最も有効ということであります。1都3県について改めて先般時間短縮の20時までの前倒しを要請をいたしました。そして国として緊急事態宣言の検討に入ります。飲食の感染リスクの軽減を実効的なものにするために、内容を早急に詰めます。さらに給付金と罰則をセットにして、より実効的な対策を取るために特措法を通常国会に提出をいたします。第二に水際対策です。年末にウイルスの変異種が帰国者から見つかり、外国人の新規入国を原則として拒否することにし、入国規制を強化をいたしています。またいわゆるビジネストラックについても、相手国の国内で変異種が発見をされた際には即時停止とすることにいたします。第三に医療体制です。特に東京をはじめとするいくつかの都市で逼迫する状況が続いております。各地域において新型コロナウイルスを受け入れる病院、病床の数、増やしていただく必要があります。国として看護師などスタッフの確保、財政支援を徹底して行うとともに、各自治体と一体となって病床確保を進めてまいります。必要ならば、自衛隊の医療チームも投入も躊躇いたしません。医療崩壊を絶対に防ぎ、必要な方に必要な医療を提供をいたします。第4にワクチンです。感染対策の決め手となるワクチンについては、当初2月中に製薬会社の治験データがまとまるということでしたが、日本政府から米国本社に対して強く要請し、 今月中にまとまる予定であります。その上で安全性高齢者施設の有効性の審査を進めて、
The facilities for elderly people, those who will be first to be vaccinated. And also, I will be willing to be vaccinated. By the time, with the central government, local governments, and the public, we have to decrease the infection. We have to be on the same page and looking at the same direction. This is the season of the New Year party. We continue to ask people to refrain from going outside unless this is necessary. The ordinary strains or variants, what we do is the same, wearing masks, washing hands, and avoiding 3Cs. These are the requests once again we want to make to the public. With the people of Japan, we have to overcome this crisis. We appreciate your support.
まずは新型コロナウイルスの感染を収束させ、
we have to put an end to the COVID-19 and then in new era Japan's economy has to grow again and we have to lead the world in order to make it happen. For the 100 days since the inauguration, we have been implementing the reform that we did not do in the past. We implement what we can do, and we deliver the outcomes to the public. This is the year we want to achieve in 2021. For mobile phone charge, the major companies have made an announcement that price is almost as half as they have right now, and we have hit the major milestones. When it comes to regional revitalization, 1 trillion 500 billion yen of the grant was utilized, will be utilized, and so that the regional economies will be revitalized in 5 years. In 15 trillion yen will be used for the resilience of the nation. We have an ambitious target for exports of the agricultural products. Beef and the rice, which is a forecast and prioritized areas, will be supported by the government. And then the driver for the growth will be digital and green. September this year, Digital Agency will be launched. So our reform will be starting in a full-fledged manner. Digital talents will be working in the private area and the central and local governments at the same time. Everyone in Japan should enjoy the benefit. That is the kind of the digital society we want to achieve. By 2050, we want to achieve the carbon neutral. At the year end, we put together the green growth strategy. We will make it more specific and we will implement with what we can do. We have a 2 trillion yen of the fund and using the tax system so that the battery, the storage will be utilized, the large investment and R&D spending will be achieved. So the growth-driven policies will be executed going forward. For years, the lower birth rate and population declining has been the significant issues for the nation. We want to achieve the year so that everyone can have a hope. For the fertility treatment, insurance coverage will be starting in April next year. Current subsidy system, we will eliminate the income threshold. The subsidy will be doubled in the second term and beyond. So we will make retrospective measures. For the next 4 years, 140,000 people on the the capacity for the children will be established so that we can eliminate the waiting lines for the children. And this is the biggest reform in 40 years. The 35 children per class will be achieved so that the education will be more nuanced and detailed for every child. Such a policy for lower birth rates and policies for the young people will continue going forward.
About COVID-19, now it's causing conflicts around the world, and we cannot see it abating still. So multinationalism is something that I'd like to focus on, and the post-COVID-19 era has to be somehow created with our leadership in place. And the most important partner is the United States. As the next president, Mr. Biden, after his inauguration, I'd like to see him as soon as possible so that the U.S.-Japan alliance can be further beefed up. And then the most important issue, abduction issue and imminent issues facing the international community, we'd like to closely collaborate with the United States. And with this alliance being linchpin, Australia and ASEAN and with other countries, we'd like to collaborate further on so that we can have a free and open Indo-Pacific, China, Russia, and with other neighboring countries, we'd like to have a stable relations forged. For the time being, COVID-19, we have to contain it as soon as possible. And at the earliest possible timing, we'd like to normalize things so that the people can be delivered security and the peace of mind and hopes. The Summer Olympics and Paralympics in Tokyo will be the testimony to people overcoming COVID-19, and rehabilitation recovery from March 11 is going to be also exhibited. So we have to have a perfect measures to contain the COVID-19, and we'd like to deliver the hopes and courage to around the world. So we'd like to make preparations towards this end. So we'd like to sow seeds for the transformation so that the people can feel the tangible effects. And afterwards, when we reflect on this year, we'd like to see this as a transformation year, which was the foundation for the new growth. So with this mindset, we'd like to continue to be a cabinet which works for the people to the best possible extent. That's all from me. So now, we'd like to have questions from the press. So I'd like to nominate who can ask questions. So please proceed to the microphone and please state your names and affiliations. And after you ask a question, please go back to your seat. And please do not ask any questions from the backward. And first of all, we'd like to take one question from two leading media outlets. Mr. Shinohara, please. TV Tokyo, my name is Shinohara. About the state of emergency declaration for Tokyo, Saitama, Kanagawa, and one more prefecture in the metropolitan area, as there will be a state of emergency declared. So that has been reported. So what is going to be the specific schedule? And if that is the case, are you going to give any cushion period for disseminating the information at the year-end period? You gave a press conference and you were precautious about delivering such a declaration. However, you have changed your mind. And what is the biggest driver that brought this change? And about go to travel? So 11th of this month, there will be the expiry of the extension or the deferment. So excluding these four metropolitan areas, are you going to lift the ban or lift the campaign halting? How do you see this? Like I said in the beginning, as a state government, the state of emergency declaration will be studied. And especially for eateries, we have to alleviate infection risks in a more effective manner. So we'd like to narrow down what has to be done. And regarding how to think about it, In Hokkaido and Osaka, we have done some shortening of business hours, and we have some tangible effects coming up. In Tokyo and so-called three metropolitan other areas during the between the New Year's period, the new infections have been happening at a quite high level in four areas in the metropolitan area. So new infections, 50% of them are accounted for by these four areas and prefectures. So we have to take it gravely, and we have to give a more stronger message. And based on such a thinking, as for the Japanese government, we'd like to ask the opinions from the advisory meeting, where we'd like to listen to their opinions. So in a specific manner, rather than clearly stating when it's going to happen, so first of all, we have to take effective measures, and we have to work out some measures for how to alleviate the E3's infection risks.
And if we declare the state of emergency, the go-to travel campaign will be difficult to resume. This is what we think. Well, I already said what I have to say. If the state of emergency is declared, it will be difficult. Once again, please do not ask additional questions from your seat. Otsuka-san from Jiji, please ask your question. I'm Otsuka from Jiji. Let me ask about the political schedule going forward. Ordinary session will be convened this month. What kind of the outcome are you going to achieve? And based on that, the LDP president tenure will be expired in September. And October, there will be the lower house, the dissolution. So what are you going to do for that? An ordinary session, supplementary budget, and a budget for the next fiscal year have to be compiled, and review of the Special Measure Act for the COVID-19, and including that, we will submit the bills. Also, establishment of the digital agency, and there are bills that are related with the 35 pupils for the class, and for the discontinuing the Hanko seal. These are the related bills, and it will be submitted, and there will be a deliberations. You also asked about the dissolution of the lower house and the LDP presidential election. For the time being, we have to prioritize COVID-19 measures as the most important agenda item. And then when we look at the Japanese economy overall, we have to take measures so that it can be on a growth track again as we go full steam ahead for those measures. Sometime in autumn, there will be an election for the lower house because there are fixed tenure. There are time constraints. We assume those time constraints, and we will consider every aspect, and we will make a judgment. We have more time until the presidential election in LDP. We have imminent issues we have to tackle. It is important to tackle those measures one by one.
Now we'd like to have questions from other media outlets, so please state your names and affiliations, and after asking your questions while wearing a mask, please go back to your seat, and we'd like to let as many outlets as possible to ask questions, so we'd like to limit the number of questions for each outlet to one. Yomiuri Newspaper, Kuromi. About the state of emergency, I have a question. Prime Minister, before, you have said the state of emergency has a severe hit on the economy activities. However, in order to alleviate any impact on the economic activities, what measures do you think you can think of? First off, Over the last course of 1 year, COVID-19 measures have been implemented. And as part of that, we have some lessons learned. As opinions of experts have exhibited, for example, in Tokyo, 60% are untraceable infections, and many of which are from drinking and eating establishments, according to what experts say. So alleviating infection risks in such restaurants and bars has to be more effective, so we'd like to take effective measures in this regard. Hokkaido, Osaka are good examples where shorter business hours was implemented. We have some tangible effects, and we have a declining trend of new cases. However, in Tokyo and surrounding areas, we haven't observed a declining trend of the new cases. It's still at a high level, so therefore, we have to take it seriously so that we can deliver a stronger message to people. Given such a situation, first of all, we have to prioritize stemming such risks sources in drinking and eating establishments. Centering on those areas, we have to take thorough measures.
Now we take another question. Egawa-san from Freelance, go ahead. I'm Egawa, freelance. I would like to make a confirmation. So you want to focus on the having the meals. So this will, so education and sports and culture was covered by the last state of emergency. It stops everything. So this time it will be different. Is that right? And then let me ask my question. Let me ask about diplomacy, particularly about China. So the Apple Daily, the founder, was detained, and Agnes Chow is now in a jail, it was reported. Tiananmen incident, appeasement policy by Japan is now come to the surface. So Prime Minister Suga, what is your opinions about those issues? So let me first ask, talk about state of emergency. For the past 1 year, we have more visibility about what lessons we have learned. And experts in advisory board will be advised, and we will make a decision. So it will be effective to take a more focused approach. I think it will be effective. And you also asked about China. Many people in Japan have the same will. They need to be democratic nation. As a Japanese government, we will send our message when it is necessary.
Now we'd like to take another question. Sugimoto-san, with Sankei newspaper. Sankei newspaper, my name is Sugimoto. So far, regarding the declaration of the state of emergency, in order not to make it happen, you tried to contain the virus and the spread. However, now the state of emergency has to be declared now. How do you see the driver of which caused the current situation? What is your take? For example, like we have mentioned, or you have mentioned, up until 20 p.m. So there was a request for shortening business hours up until this timing. However, Tokyo didn't respond. So if Tokyo had responded to such a request from the state government, do you think the state of emergency declaration could have been avoided? In Tokyo and surrounding areas, December turnout wasn't did not shrink. And during New Year's period, we didn't observe a declining trend. So we have to take it more seriously, and we have to give a stronger message. So that was a decision that we exercised. The infection status, all in all, across the nation, around 2 weeks, about 50% of the new infections are coming from these four prefectures in metropolitan area. So having observed such a trend, the Japanese government has met with the four governors and their requests are one of the drivers. However, all in all, the four prefectures in the metropolitan area are contributing a lot negatively to the COVID-19 trends. So therefore, we'd like to exercise the right decision with that in mind. However, this is about the virus and about the hypothesis. I will not give you any affirmative comments.
We will take a few more questions. Freelance Okawa-san, please ask a concise question. Happy New Year. I'm Okawa, freelance. Thank you. I'm in charge of the people. I go to the places where there are people with mental disability and intellectual disability. There are the children who cannot really control themselves. So for those people, it is difficult to be in an accommodation facility. So they cannot really be staying in accommodation. There are measures like zoning. We attended a study group with the health ministry. DMAT is dispatched when there's a cluster infection. On a daily basis, the zoning are taken in care facilities. However, the policies are inconsistent based on prefecture. Nara prefecture may take 20 people, but it is difficult to mobilize or move people from other prefectures. So it is very important to see the very clear message from the central government. So I want to know what you think about this. When I was an assembly member of the Yokohama, I was a chair of the group to achieve the bonds with the people. So I think I understand the reality. You explained that there are different measures based on the different places. Central government will issue the clear message so that people with disability can be treated without worries. This is kind of the support we want to give as a central government.
Sorry, because of the schedule afterwards, so we'd like to end this session now. And the people who are raising their hand and who want to ask questions, so please give one question for each outlet by email, and we'd like to give you answers in writing later on from Prime Minister. So this concludes the press conference of Prime Minister. Thank you very much for your cooperation.